Mr. Korsak was a famous book author, specifically for children, who opened up a Jewish orphanage in Warsaw. When the war started to break out and the orphanage was moved to the ghetto, when 192 children in the orphanage were selected for deportation, he was offered sanctuary on the Aryan side, but refused. Him and most of the children were sent to the showers upon arrival at Treblinka. This shows that within tragedy, heroes are born. He's honored by the State of Israel as a righteous among the nation. עמד עלינו לכלותינו והיא שעמד על אבותינו והיא שעמדה לאבותינו ולנו שלא אחד בלבד עמד עלינו לכלותינו.
When we were in Warsaw, we visited the remnants of the ghetto wall. It was so surreal to be standing in front of it, of a wall that enclosed thousands of our own ancestors only around 75 years ago, while also standing right next to apartment buildings where people are living today. Before we left, we all started to sing Vihisha Amda, a song that I think after the trip, we all feel a really big connection with. As we got to the chorus, a man living in the apartment directly next to the wall began to yell at us. Instead of stopping, our chaperones told us to sing even louder. The sense of unity we felt in this moment made us realize how important it was to remain united and faithful, especially for those who died fighting for it.
לאבותינו ולנו שלא אחד בלבד עמד עלינו לכלותינו עמד עלינו לכלותינו והקדוש ברוך הוא מצילנו מצילנו מידם.
This trip to Poland gave me the chance to physically experience the history of the Holocaust as best as a member of the 21st century could. While visiting the concentration camps, I always made sure to reach out and touch the objects I was exposed to, although I can never truly comprehend what it was like to live through the Holocaust. Touching the oven in a crematorium or the wooden planks of a cattle car enabled me to formulate my textual knowledge into an emotional reality.
On the third day of our mission, we visited a mass children's grave located in a forest just a 5-minute walk from a neighborhood in the city of Tarnow. Innocent children were taken from their families and homes because the Germans wanted more living space in the city. In order to accomplish this goal, they took 6,000 children, shot them one by one, and threw them into a pit. As I was walking down the same path that these children took and standing by their grave, I tried to fathom the fear that they had while walking to their death. It was completely unimaginable. I couldn't comprehend how people could take someone's life away for no reason at all, especially a child's life. Their lives were taken before they even had an opportunity to live.
Have a leadership position to make sure that you tell over and you teach over the story and the Masorah of our people, of Klal Yisrael.
Thank you. Visiting Majdanek was one of the most significant, life-changing parts of my trip. The camp is basically fully intact and can be up and running again with the flip of a switch. My heart was aching as I walked around there and stood in a place where hundreds of thousands of Jews were murdered. While standing lined up in front of the pits, I started getting extremely emotional. This was the exact spot and exact position where many had experienced their last seconds of life. Staring into those pits, I imagined how 75 years ago, the people right there were in a line, just as we were, about to be shot. It was quite terrifying. It made me recognize the important things in my life and began to truly cherish my life and everything it holds. The feeling of standing there is one I will never forget.
סלח לי אבי כי חטאתי לך מחולי על כל פשעי גם בימים ששכחתי אותך היית תמיד בחיי בכל הדרכים שהלכתי בעצם היית לי נר לרגלי הייתי עיוור לא ראיתי מעבר למה שהביטו עיניי מלך מלכי המלכים תודה על חיים על עושר על בכי על צחוק גם כשקשה לפעמים גם אז אלוקים אתה לעולם לא רחוק מלך מלכי המלכים תודה על חיים על עושר על בכי על צחוק גם כשקשה לפעמים גם אז אלוקים אתה לעולם לא רחוק גם כי אלך בדרכי חשוכה בטחתי בך אלוקיי על חצי שני על בכור וילדה תודה גם על אושר בלידיי תודה על חגים על שבת ששומרת שלא ייגמר לעולם כל יום שעובר בדרכי לגן עדן שיביתי אותך מול עיניי מלך מלכי המלכים תודה על חיים על עושר על בכי על צחוק גם כשקשה לפעמים